Hello, I'm Jeff Kelly with SUU Aviation, and today I want to talk about the basics of magnetos, not Ian McKellen magnetos, but magnetos here and our M6 tester, which we test them on. Magnetos were invented over 100 years ago, and they're primarily used in aviation, and you can also find them in tractors, lawnmowers, chainsaws, and small marine boat engines. Magnetos on aircraft work independently of the electrical system, i.e. the generator, the alternator, or the battery. So in the event that you have a main power supply failure on your aircraft, you still are able to fly with the magneto, providing ignition for your combustion engine. Parts of your magneto consist of your main rotor, which is your PMG, that drives an electromagnetic force to your primary and secondary windings. Inside of this is primary and secondary windings that induce voltage from this tab into your distributor block to each cylinder. Also here is your capacitor inside the casing here that provides or prevents premature electrical discharge in the system. Some magnetos have impulse couplings on them. The impulse coupling allows for a quick turn or RPM revolution of the magneto to induce voltage into the combustion chamber. So if you've ever seen a manual start, say World War I aircraft, a manual start where they pull the propeller, that is inducing voltage via the impulse coupling to allow the engine to turn over and start. You have the distributor housing, and you have the magneto housing. And the magneto housing contains the primary and secondary coil and the rotor, PMG rotor. The distributor housing holds the distributor block itself and the gearing, the spline gearing that goes into and turns your distributor rotor. As the rotor turns, it has a cam on the end of it that lifts up the contact points and creates an open. Normally, the primary winding is grounded. The electromagnetic energy from the primary coil is now transferred to the secondary coil. Once the secondary coil is energized, it is now brought to the distributor cap and pushed out through each cylinder, depending on the distributor cap and where it's set, to which cylinder fires first. Our M6 tester allows us the capability of checking the voltage and the spark of each cylinder once it's in its full revolution, all the way up to a certain RPM. And we can induce that by this control panel here. So I have forward and reverse. You have to make sure that you check and see what type of magneto you have, whether it be right turn or left rotation, right rotation or left rotation. And then you set it to either forward or reverse. This particular magneto has an impulse coupling attached to it. So you're gonna hear the impulse coupling click, and that is doing a quick revolution of the rotor to induce voltage for start. So this is how normally, if you have a starter on the aircraft, the starter's gonna turn the engine, and the engine's going to turn the magneto very slowly, but not enough for ignition. However, added with the impulse coupling, you now have a spark to provide combustion. So we'll start off and you'll hear the impulse coupling click. You can see the sparks of each cylinder. One thing that's important to note that even while starting and during full operation all the way up to cruising RPM, you want to make sure you have good sparks at each cylinder. If you don't have good sparks at each cylinder, that will be key to tell you that there's something wrong with your magneto or it's not timed properly. So now I'll bring it up to about 2000 RPM, cruising speed of some aircraft. And I can leave it there for a certain amount of time, watching each spark. Make sure that it's good. Another important aspect to your magneto is whether you can turn it on and off. For safety, default, or the magneto is defaulted to stay on and operate so long as the engine is turning. It's important to take a good look at your magneto in operation, but also in the absence of operation or when you want to actually stop the engine. Earlier, I talked about how if you have a main electrical failure in your aircraft, your magneto will still run. So how do you shut off a magneto? There's a switch with your key in the cockpit, normally, on most aviation or most aircraft that will you'll be able to turn off, go to left magneto, right magneto, both, and start. If you want to turn it off, that's taking what you call a P-lead, and you're grounding it out. If you ground out a magneto, it will turn off. And so you will see the sparks disappear if this magneto and this tester is hooked up right. So now you have officially turned off the engine with the key. But in this case, it's the switch. The automotive industry eventually turned over to away from magnetos. One of the main reasons is because in order to turn off an engine with a magneto, you can either turn and ground the magneto or you starve it of fuel. And in the aviation, it's most safe to starve the engine of fuel. That way, if somebody comes along with the key in ignition in both left or right, and they turn the prop, it could combust whatever's left in the cylinder. The automotive industry eventually turned to distributors and coils, and then later on to electronic ignition systems. That's it for this video. If you liked it, be sure to comment below and like and subscribe as well. And as always, never quit, never give up, and fly it to the end.